aspirants who want to participate in the competition, one thing is that one needs to be totally clear with regards to what the objective is. So, for example, there are certain competitions with which students want to just go ahead and, you know, for the money they want to just compete. That is good. But then there are certain competitions that provide you opportunity that might actually help in building your career. For example, I participated in the Economic Times Young Leader competition. And truth be told, I'm sitting here at the ABG offices after winning the competition. So, yeah, for students who are really eager into making it big in the B school, applying to competitions, giving their best, identifying their strengths. If a competition is like that of a, you know, you need to participate as a team, you need to make sure that all your partners are someone who are experts in their own field. And if it's like a solo competition, then you need to be really sure that yes, you have to go up till the end. So you have to really have that tenacity inside you that can, you know, help you pass that 1 month or 2 month of that entire process and can help you reach the entire goal.
For ET Violence Stratos, the only suggestion to participants, I'll say in a very different and a candid way, as we have been at campus in our lives, be serious about what you're doing. Just don't apply for the sake of applying. Just get into it, because there are employers who are looking out to recruit you from that pool. So when you apply for it, go and deep dive into it, study about it and learn through it.
We tend to do is whenever we start doing a case study, we start looking at what could be the current business scenario, what is the, you know, what the business is currently into, and then later on we just focus on our current project or case. We forget how the business is going to get impacted by your case. So maybe you are doing a marketing case, you will build a very good marketing case, but you need to understand whether the operational supply chain of the company would support that or not. So you need to look at other aspects of the business while you are doing a specialized case study.
When you are participating in a competition, I think the only thing to remember is that the people who are who are going to be judging you really don't care about like how nice a PPT you make or what sort of frameworks you use. For them, and I only know this now, like because I didn't win any of them, but I only know this now that when they are looking for a solution, they are looking to see in numbers what impact you're making. So it doesn't, like as students, I think probably even I did that, I used to think that, you know, doing a really nice presentation and going out of our way and doing something fancy makes a lot of sense. But to someone who's coming in, they need to be simply told that, hey, like this is what is going to work for you, and when you put in so much, this is what you're going to get out of that. So I think, and even because of the way we are taught, that probably isn't something that any of our professors would, you know, sit down and tell us because it's a competition. But yeah, like I think simple things, but more of like what business impact you're going to have should work.